I'm going to take out the drum motor now, and I'm just looking at the service manual. There's two screws here on this side, the black one, on this side. Lights out. Also, this here seems to be flopping about. Take another way. And what I normally do is I stick a few screws back in so I know where everything goes. Especially odd screws like that, black. I'm going to take out this drum, or the, I'm going to take out this loading motor now. There's two screws holding it in. It's a load motor out. And likewise, I'm going to stick these screws back in as well. It saves a lot of time when you're reassembling. You don't have to worry about what screw is which. And of course, I have this black screw that went down the center of the for the head. Retain the head as well. I think there are three black screws. Let's just put that back in this place. Next step. I'm going to take off the pinch roller assembly now. There's a washer here that's going to be very hard to remove. When I say hard, I mean impossible. The washer nearly out. That's in there. Very small, very hard to see. Will be easy to lose. Just gonna lift up the pinch roller assembly now. The pinch roller assembly. Next component I'm going to remove is the exit guide arm here, and that's held in by a little washer down here, and it's going to be another difficult washer to take out. Difficult. It out. just going to remove this exit guide arm now. And out comes. Contains the head cleaner as well, that's the automatic head cleaner. I'm going to now remove this middle catcher assembly. There's three screws holding it in place. And it lifts out. Next step is to remove this wheel cover assembly. There is a screw down here, right beside the take-up wheel. Should slide forward and then out. This is where you have to be careful now, because the components now can just fall about if you turn the deck upside down. There's nothing to hold these gears in place. I'm going to now remove the idler arm assembly. It should just pull up now, out of the way. Yes. I'm just going to start working on this back tension arm here. At this location here. And we have a back tension adjustment here. I just want to put a marking on this so I get it into the same position. I'll just mark it with some black marker. And what I'm going to do is just going to take any excess off it now. First thing I'm going to take now is this washer off. There's a washer right here at this particular point. Next step I'm going to do is I'm going to try and get this arm up. There is a spring. It should lift up out of the way. Maybe I'll take the spring off first. That's that off. Should lift up straight, back tension arm, back tension brake, I should say. want to rub my mark in the office. You can see my black mark. I'm going to remove now the sub-deck assembly. There's 5 screws in it. One here. And one over here on the left hand side. Then we have one here as well, which is very loose. So this one here, I should say. Very clear from the diagram which one it is. I'm going to chance this one here. Yes, that's a little loose. Seems to be catching on there, this particular place here. Is that because it's out of alignment? I don't know. So what I'm going to do is, for this particular one, even though the instructions don't tell you to do this, I'm going to take this little thing off, take it out of the way, just so I can see what I'm doing. Okay, I'm just going to push this arm up here, and that brings that up just enough. There's a silver piece here that's trapping it. Just brings it up enough to get it above it. We are in a position now to see some of our timing marks. The loading arms themselves have a timing mark here, a little point here, and run straight across there. If you look at it, I'll just get a secret, get a closer shot. The 2 points of this. There, so that's correct as for the diagram of the service manual. So I'm not worried about that end of it. I'm just going to have to check the rest of it now. I'm going to have to dig a little bit deeper now to get in further, check out these timing marks. Get this out of the way first. And we've got another little clip here. I'm going to use the same process this time as I put the other small clips. I normally try to jam one side of it. Push the other upwards. That's the clip off. This arm should come up now. Diamond marks don't look right. I can't get any of them to line up. It's loading now. Unloading. Okay. We've got these diamond marks here lined up. A little notch that lines up with a little arrow on this here, and he lines up there. Now I've got to check on the right hand side here. We got a mechanism over this side. See how that aligns up with this. This seems to be okay here. Nothing amiss there.